With the belt a few years ago, and then the Rose Namajunas rematch.
I can say I'm more hungry because I'm always hungry. I love to challenge myself, and I'm. It's not only about willing to put on work, but it's all about putting on actual work. And I'm super excited to be in this spot. I've been working so hard to be here, be the pretender, the challenger for the UFC Strawweight belt again. And I'm super happy. You know, I'm so motivated, so disciplined, and there was nothing between.
Joanna, there was some concern in Tampa about your weight during fight week.
And it was the easiest weight cut in Tampa. And this time I woke up 123, guys. So it's like nothing. If you ask the fighters, it's like nothing. Probably I will just break a sweat this tonight. And I'm still drinking 2 gallons of liquid every single day, eating 3 meals a day, 2 snacks. Clint from Performance Institute is an amazing guy, but I'm using my knowledge as well, and it's amazing, you know. So I really don't have to do a bath, I really don't have to go to the sauna. There is not going to be impact on my body, my mind. I'm not going to stress my body and mind, so I will recover faster after the weigh-ins and be ready, man. Be ready.
Why is it so much easier now than it was? Because you had a hard time for many years.
Yeah. 115. You know, wrong people. You know, because like in this business, like when you make it to the top and when you're the champ, there is so many obligations, so many stuff. And I'm always willing to do and more. But sometimes you need people around to help you. You know, you need an assistant, you need a good management. Finally, I found a good management company, because you know that I've been with a few different people, but Valenji Group and Jennifer, who is responsible for me, Lloyd, they are putting on a hell of a work, and I'm very blessed with them. But the other thing is, like, same with the nutritionists, you know? They're trying things, you know, but They were never an athlete, you know. Maybe they read the books about, but it's a science for them, you know. Eat, you're gonna be fine. No, at the end, we fighters have to struggle, you know. I broke my hand 2 times, fight after the fight, you know, because of the wrong diet, you know. And I used to, like, you know, I'm happy that I'm alive after what happened in New York before Rose fight, you know, the first Rose fight. So just the knowledge, I'm more smart, I trust, I listen to my body more, and I trust myself more.
She's been through a lot of stuff during this training camp. She had to move like twice, like she's through training camp, she has to leave her country. You're someone who likes to get in opponents' heads before the fight. Does this make you not want to do it? Do you think that she's kind of been through enough, or are you going to still try to get in her head?
She has been through enough, you know. I love my country, and you know, I can only imagine how she feels about, you know, how she's feeling about that. But it is what it is, you know. Sometimes life looks like this, you know. And I remember my first title fight, and UFC called me like 3 weeks before the fight, and they said, like, hey, you need to pack your stuff, and in 2 days we need you in LA, we need you in Vegas, we need you in Dallas. And I was like, oh, what the heck, I need to be focused on training, finish my camp. But you know, we all have to go through this, you know. When you becoming the UFC champion, champion of simply the best MMA organization in the world, you need to deal with all of this, you know. But of course, it was not her fault that she had to travel so much. But you know, she's finally here, it's been 2 weeks, she could adjust to the time, to the climate. I think we are going to put on hell of a fight, and it's going to be the best strawweight fight in the UFC history.
You're one of the so many sporting events have been kind of shut down at different schools, different events because of the virus.
I know.
Have you changed the way you approach things with either fans or your workouts or anything?
Yeah. Yes, I do. Like, especially in Europe, this coronavirus got really crazy. People are really panicking, you know, in Poland. Like, in Italy, the situation is very bad, and in Switzerland, in Poland as well, you know. And people canceling the traveling trips, holiday, and the business is going down. So it's really crazy. And I feel like in the States, you don't feel it that much, you know. But I'm very happy that, you know, after working so hard for so many weeks, finally I can step on big stage here in Vegas and show what I've been working for so many weeks. So definitely, I feel very happy.
Have you changed any of your approach in terms of like shaking hands with fans?
No, come on, it's all about, I'm trying to be safe, you know. It's important to not get any infection before the fight. I usually, like, I'm a very clean person, you know, so no, you know, if something gonna happen, it's going to happen, you know. It doesn't matter what, you know. So I don't want to stay home and like cover myself, put a mask or use hand sanitizer all the time. No, I'm trying to like prevent some things, but I'm not crazy about it.
Your sister is here too, right?
Yeah. You know, my family been traveling with me always. My twin sister came down here. My older sister stayed home with mom. But my nephew is here. It's first time my father is to the States, and he was to my first title defense, what was in Berlin in 2015. But man, I'm super happy to have him here. I'm proud of him because I know how much energy it cost him. He was only on one plane, like to Denmark from Poland. It's like 1.5 hour. This trip was long to LA, from also to LA, and they got here last night very late. But I'm very happy, and it's a big support, you know. So good to have him here. My best friends, family. I'm so blessed with that. You know, it's extra power.
Last question, guys.
Joanna, she said this fight isn't
going to
go.
She's going to knock me out.
Yeah, and this fight won't go 5 rounds. Yeah.
So
you have a
so
lot.
So that's why I got like. Nice, this is what I was missing in my last fight. You know, when I step into the octagon, you know, and I always walk like this, I was like, ooh, JJ, it's time. And, you know, I respect all the fighters, and I love Michelle Waterson, love Jager, all the best. And the thing is that I need this sports violence, you know, I need this aggression. So her saying this, that's what's up, you know. Jessica Andrade said the same, that she was going to knock me out. These girls, they look that short, they look muscular, they look so powerful. She has this power, you know, but I know how to avoid it. You know, she can try, she can face the best in the business. And she knows that she needs me to make this money and become a superstar of the strawweight division in the UFC, you know. And there are people who doubting me or they're going to do that, but my legacy is so big, you know, so that's the thing. But so she's her saying this and me hearing this, I feel like, okay, this got real, let's go, let's rock and roll on Saturday. It doesn't matter what I'm going to say, it doesn't matter what she's going to say, it's all about the fight on Saturday, you know? And I know how well prepared I am.
How do you see it unfolding?
The fight?
Yeah.
I want to make her quit. I'm a real fight runner. I've been through so many fights. It's my 14th fight in the UFC, 10th for the belt. I had a few 5 rounds fights, and I'm a naturally gifted fighter athlete with such a good condition, and I want to make them quit, you know? I want to make her quit and beg me to stop, you know? And this is what's going to happen, you know? Of course, one punch can finish the fight, but I know that I'm ready for anything and everything, and I don't want to this person who is going to say like, I will knock you out, I will submit you. No, it's not a lottery, you know. You have to take fight second by second. That's it.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.